Dinesh sir, you can start.
Healthy morning to everyone. I welcome you all for the fifth day of this faculty development program on the topic classification and application of fuzzy sets. Thank you all for your support. I welcome our secretary, Dr. S. Arivaragi, our principal, Dr. P. Suresh Mohan Kumar, heads of various departments and faculty members for this six-day faculty development program on applications of mathematics in diverse fields organized by Department of Mathematics, Anand Institute of Higher Technology. On behalf of Anand Institute of Higher Technology, I extend a heartfelt welcome to our resource person, Dr. R. Muthuraj, Assistant Professor, PG and Research Department of Mathematics, HS the Rajas College, Pudukkottai. And I heartily welcome all the faculty members and research scholars from various colleges. Now I would like to call Mrs. K. Kritika, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, to introduce the resource person.
Very good morning to all. It's my honor and privilege to introduce our speaker, Dr. R. Muthuraj, Assistant Professor, PG and Research Department of Mathematics, H.H. Rajas College, Pudukkottai. He has 23 years of experience in teaching profession. Dr. Muthuraj has completed his PhD in Allahabad University in the field of fuzzy algebra and fuzzy mathematics and its applications. He has published 145 national and international journals. Dr. Muthuraj is recognized as a research supervisor at Anna University of Technology, Madurai and Bharathidasan University, Trichy. Under his guidance, 10 students have completed their PhD degree and 6 students are pursuing their PhD. I am proud to say I am one among them. Dr. Muthuraj has been invited as a resource person at several colleges. He has presented his research findings in many national and international conferences. He is the life member of Indian Society of Technical Education. Once again, on behalf of Anand Institute of Higher Technology, I welcome you, sir. Now, you, I hand over this session to Dr. Muthuraj.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your good words. Ma'am, is it audible?
Yes, sir. Okay, ma'am? Yeah, okay. Fine.
Presentation, is it clear, ma'am?
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Good morning to one and all. It's my immense pleasure to thank the pertinent Dr. S. Arivaragi, MPPS Secretary, ma'am, the convener, Dr. P. Suresh Kumar, sir, principal, sir, and the organizer, Dr. Meena S. Hachodi, ma'am, and Mr. V. V. Rajasekaran, sir, and the coordinators, Mrs. K. Kritika, ma'am, and Mr. P. Chinnasamy, sir, Mr. B. Krishnan, sir, and the other faculty members of Anand Institute of Higher Technology, Chennai, for organizing this 6 days FDP on application of mathematics in diverse fields to share knowledge in various fields of mathematics during this COVID-19 pandemic situation. Today, I am going to share my views on the topic classification and application of fuzzy set. I had planned to explain the concept of fuzzy sets, intuitionistic fuzzy set, bipolar valued fuzzy sets, and multi fuzzy sets mathematically and graphically with the example and some real life applications. My basic intention is to share the idea of how the intuitionistic fuzzy set, bipolar fuzzy set, and multi fuzzy set are in need to have an extension from fuzzy sets. Now I start the session. Content. Today I am planned to present fuzzy set definition both mathematically and graphically, operations on fuzzy sets and some of its applications, classifications. I take the three types of fuzzy sets. One is intuitionistic fuzzy set, another bipolar fuzzy set, and multi fuzzy set. The definition of set is a collection of well-defined distinct objects. Any element from universe of discourse can be identified as either that element belong to that set or not. Any set can be associated with a function called characteristic function. Characteristic function, the definition, let X be the universe of discourse and its element be denoted as X. In the classical set theory, the characteristic function of a set capital A of X is defined as a function F A of X. F A of X is a function from capital X, that is universe of discourse to to the set 0, 1 where fi of x equal to 1 if x belongs to A and 0 if x doesn't belong to A. As we are all mathematics professors, and we know about set and characteristic function and its properties. Whenever we have to say set, it has a definition, the wording well defined, because of the wording well defined, it means that there is no element on that boundary because the boundary is so sharp. So if we have any element from the universe of discourse, we can say that either that element completely lies in the subset A of X or not. That is, I am going to take one example for a crisp set. That is, here I am considering several persons and their heights. And now I have to take the set
Sorry for the interruption, sir. I kindly request the participants to not to share their screen and please kindly mute your audio and video. Kindly do not disturb the presenter. Thank you.
Whose height is given below, and now I consider the set capital A as whose height is above 180 centimeter. So that only I have given the membership value whose height is of 180 centimeter as 1, and the remaining thing I have to take it as 0 because of characteristic function definition. And the graphical representation of a set is in this manner. The persons whose height is of below 180, I have to assign the value 0. And the persons whose height is of above 180, I have to give the membership value as 1. So the diagram is like this. Next, membership. Membership means these are the two-value logic. How it has to be extended into multi-value logic. But in real-life situation, with this 0, 1, we are not able to do anything. That's why we have to assign for membership value. Suppose, as we are the professors, in a classroom, suppose we have to give 4 problems as a homework. Next day, we come and ask how many students completed all those 4 problems. We take it as a set A. And for those peoples, we have to give chocolates, 1 full chocolate to each of them. So definitely there should be some persons who do not complete all those homeworks. So one of the person come near to you and ask, I have completed 2 problems, and give me half chocolate means that. But in real time situation, as we are the motivating professor, we have to give half chocolate and we have to encourage him. Then only he will try to do all those sums in future. Okay, that is in real life situation. So we have to give off chocolate and we have to bring him. Next, what the thing you have to automatically, the person who have completed 3 problems automatically near you to, and he requested for 3/4 of the chocolate. That also you have to do. The person who completed 1 problem and near you and asked you 1/4 of the chocolate. That also you have to do. Otherwise, you are not able to motivate means that if you are not motivated them means that in future they won't obey you, though they won't do any sums. Okay, so because of they are trying now, so you have to motivate them, so you have to do it. This is a real life situation. So in the situation you have to do. Now our membership function is like this. See, here the boundary is so sharp. This is the persons, the set A consists of all those persons who completed all the 4 problems. Here the boundary is somewhat wider. So you have to, in this boundary only, you have to keep the persons who completed 3 sums, 2 sums and 1 sums. Okay, so the person who do not complete the sums, you have to keep them here, and the persons who completed sums, you have to keep inside the set A. So now the two-value logic becomes multi-value logic in this sense in real life. Similarly, how the fuzzy set has been introduced, see here. Consider the set capital A equal to set of all x belongs to n. N means a set of all natural number. X greater than or equal to 5. Like you have to consider the set capital A. If A is like this, then automatically you can list out the elements 5, 6, 7, etc. Suppose another set you have to consider B set of all x belongs to n such that x is double greater than means that you can call it as much greater than 5. Then much greater than 5 means that I can say much greater than means that it is it starts from 15. Another one say no, it starts from 20. Another one say no, it may starts from 50. So this much greater than varies from person to person. Is 8, 10, 5 or members of B means that it is doubtful because one person say yes, another person say no. it is doubtful to list the elements of B. It is because of the variable X undergoes a condition much greater than, which is not certain, but 1,000, 10,000 are members of B, which all agrees, because definitely 1,000 and 10,000 are much greater than 5. Hence, we introduce the membership values. To resolve uncertainty, membership values are introduced. Because of the well-defined property of a set, given any element from the universal set U, then we can say that is it belongs to or completely lies in the set capital A. This assumes that each element of U can be assigned either the values 0 or 1 corresponding to the set capital A. Then the set or the property is treated as a proposition or the statement, and these values 0 and 1 are treated as the truth values, I mean two value logic. Now you have to consider the statement capital A as I am a liar. If the truth value of capital A is 1, then what is the meaning here? Then what I am saying is a lie. Then so I am not a liar automatically. Then if the truth value of A is 0, then what I am saying is true. So I am a liar. So similarly, you have to consider another statement. The sentence is false. If the truth value of B is 1, then it states that the sentence is false. If the truth value of B is 0, then it states that the sentence is true. See, for these two statements A and B is true or false at the same time. Therefore, it is not possible to allocate the truth value 0 and 1 with this. So we have to go for the next thing. To overcome this difficulty, in 1930, John Lukoszewski and Alfred Tarsik defined a three-valued logic. One more value he has to include, and later generalized to n-value and infinitely many-valued variants. According to his theory, the truth value set capital T equal to 0, 1 by n minus 1, 2 by n minus 1, etc. n minus 1 by n minus 1. That is, from 0 to 1, there should be n values. So this is called n truth values here. N, that is n-valued logic. Then you can allow this n tends to infinity means that we can get infinitely many valued variants. So according to this theory, that is theory means that John Lukoszewski's theory, the statement A and B is true and false at the same time. The truth value or membership value of this statement is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means that between 0 and 1, we can find the value 1 by 2. So this is a 3-value logic. Later, it is extended to n-value logic according to our needs and wants. So introduction of a fuzzy set. Next one, say next stage, consider the statement A of x equal to x is close to 2. That is, this is predicate calculus. X is a real number like that we have to consider. So x is a real number. X close to 2 means that close to 2, there should be uncountable number of members. So uncountable number of members, we are not able to put in this n-valued logic or infinitely n-valued logic. We are not able to put the truth values of this uncountable set. So that's why we have to go for the next one. In 1965, Professor L.A. Jardy generalizes John Lukoszewski and Alfred Tarsik logic and defined fuzzy logic with the truth values lie in closed interval 0,1. That is, closed interval 0,1 means it is uncountable set. So this uncountable number of the truth values of this uncountable number close to 2 can be determined from this uncountable set only. That is, any function capital A from x to closed interval 0,1 is called fuzzy set. Here, the codomain of the characteristic function is extended from 0,1 into closed interval 0,1. 1965, fuzzy sets introduced by L.A. Jardy. So he is Professor L.A. Jardy. In 1965, L.A. Jardy, professor of EEE, University of California, Berkeley, introduced the concept of fuzzy sets. And he is called as father of fuzzy logic. Fuzzy sets is characterized by membership function, which assigns grade of membership between 0 and 1. Fuzzy logic allows intermediate values to be defined between the conventional evaluation like 0 or 1, true or false, yes or no, high or low, etc. That is, between 0 and 1, the values are exist. Between true and false, the values are exist. Between yes and no, there are some values. Like that, fuzzy logic only we have to know. Jardy passed away on 6th September 2017 at the age of 96 years. The membership degree 1 indicates that an element completely belongs to its corresponding fuzzy set. The membership degree 0 indicates that an element does not belong to fuzzy set. The membership degree 0 on the interval 0, 1 indicates the partial membership to the fuzzy set. That is, all crisp sets are fuzzy sets, but the converse is not true. All crisp sets can be treated as a fuzzy set by giving membership value 1 to all its elements. It automatically becomes a fuzzy set. So the same example here, once again, I'm considering for the tall man problem. So the same height is given. Now we are dealing this the same problem with the fuzzy set. Fuzzy set means that not 0, 1. We can allow in between, including 0 and 1, any value in between that. So for the lower value, I start from 0. And for the higher value, I finish it to be 1. So randomly, I have given the values. So the graph for this one looks like this. This is a graphical representation of a fuzzy set. So another notion to denote a fuzzy sets for the real number x closer to 2. So close to 2, there should be uncountable numbers so that you can denote it in this manner. Operation on fuzzy sets. First, I define the operation fuzzy set operation, subset operation. Let x be the universe of discourse. Let A and B be fuzzy sets on X, then A is a fuzzy subset of B, if and only if A of X less than or equal to B of X for all X belong X in capital X. Consider the following two sets, A and B on capital X equal to, now X, I take it to be ABCD. Just for an example, I have considered these four elements. I am defining A and B in my own random. So given the values in between 0 and 1, see here, A of X less than, all those things A of X, and here A of X equal to B of X and all other thing A of X less than B of X. So clearly A of X is less than or equal to B of X for all X. Then the fuzzy set capital A is a fuzzy subset of a fuzzy set capital B. Graphically, we can represent like this. See, this color, green color is fuzzy set A and this one is of fuzzy set B. So fuzzy set A is completely lies within fuzzy set B. Okay, next. Operation, the same subset operation. Here also I am going to define the two things. Here A of, for the element A of X is greater than B of X. And for the element B, see here A of X is less than B of X. So neither A is a fuzzy subset of B, nor B is a fuzzy subset of A. Okay. So the graphical representation of this one is like this. There is some overlapping. So A is not a subset of B and vice versa. Union of two fuzzy sets. Let A be a fuzzy set defined on X and B be a fuzzy set defined on Y. Then the union of two fuzzy sets A and B be denoted by A union B as a fuzzy set on X union Y, and its membership function is defined as A union B of X equal to A of X if X belongs to X minus Y, B of X if X belongs to Y minus X, maximum of A of X comma B of X for all X belongs to X intersection Y. That is, if X belongs to both the fuzzy sets A and B, then we have to choose the maximum among them. Otherwise, you have to keep that their membership value as it is in their union. See, graphical representation. See here, this is one fuzzy set capital A and this is one fuzzy set capital B. Union means that, so you have to consider like this. Up to this, that is up to this, there is no intersection with A and B. Okay, if it is intersection with A and B, you have to take down the maximum. Okay. Similarly, union we are drawing using our Excel format. So AB, so we are given the membership value. Among both, you have to take down the maximum one. So your union B is like this. So fuzzy set A is denoted in this manner and the fuzzy set B is denoted in this manner. Union means that for each and every point A, B, C, D, I have to consider maximum and this is the union of fuzzy set A and fuzzy set B. And similarly, you can define for intersection. Intersection means that, see, A intersection B of X equal to minimum of A of X comma B of X. So minimum value only you have to consider. So in the same diagram, intersection means that automatically minimum value only you have to consider. So it should be like this only. This darkened curve is nothing but intersection of the fuzzy set A and B. Similarly, intersection of fuzzy set, the same set we have to take, we have to consider here the minimum value only. So the same like we are drawing the graphs. So the minimum, we have a graph of this format. Complement. Complement means that, say, complement of a fuzzy set A is defined as the set of membership value 1 minus A of x, where A of x is the membership value of the given fuzzy set. A complement of x equal to 1 minus A of x for all x belongs to x. Complement of a fuzzy set. See here, x equal to A, B, C, D, and let A and B be two fuzzy sets of x as given below. A equal to B equal to this membership value, so randomly I have to take. Okay, so next A complement I have to calculate. A complement means the 1 minus A of x. So we are given that value. Similarly, B complement means the 1 minus B of x. So it is listed in the table. See here, the first diagram shows that A, the fuzzy set A and its complement. Okay, the second diagram shows that the fuzzy set B and its complement. Okay, next, the relation between set and fuzzy set. So automatically from set only we are fuzzy set defining, so there is some relation or that there should be some law. Okay, as well as we are saying that the converse part is not true, that is not all fuzzy sets are sets like that. For that we have to give some counter example also. So there are two rules, law of excludability and law of contradiction. These two rules everybody well know. This is true in set theory, that we know. Okay, so how it fails in fuzzy set theory, let us see. Suppose let us take A is a fuzzy set. A is a fuzzy set means that automatically A complement is a fuzzy set. So in the fuzzy set A, you have to choose an element x in that fuzzy set A, and you have to put the membership value of this x is 0.7. okay, then automatically the membership value of x in A complement is nothing but 0.3. okay, now A union A complement, and the membership value of x in A union A complement, we have to see means that maximum of that 0.3 and 0.7, so which is equal to 0.7, which is not equal to 1, because x means that universe of discourse, if that element should be in x means that membership value should be 1, that membership value should be 1, so which is not true in the case of fuzzy set. Similarly, law of contradiction you have to consider. The same element for x, for the fuzzy set, the membership value is 0.7, and its complement, its membership value is 0.3. Then you have to consider the intersection means that minimum among 0.3 and 0.7, that is equal to 0.3 only. So 0.3 means that which is not equal to 0, so that only that element doesn't belong to 5. 5 means that, so that only what is that? These two properties are failed in fuzzy sets. Support of a fuzzy set. Support. Let A be a fuzzy set on X. Let X belongs to X such that A of X greater than 0 is called a support of A. That is, for all those element X belongs to X whose membership value is greater than 0 is called a support. Similarly, for all X belongs to X whose membership value equal to 1 is called a core. Here you have to consider one set capital X as elements A, B, C, D, E, and we are given membership values of this element. See, for the element C, I am given as 0. That's why it is not in support of A. All the other elements are in support of A. So this is the support of A diagram. Up to this it is 0. After that it is slightly increases and reaches its maximum and below like this. Okay. So these elements are in support of A because the membership value of these elements is greater than 0. So core. Core means what is that? Set of all X whose membership values are equal to 1. Equal to 1 means that you have to consider, you have to collect all those elements because these elements whose membership values are greater than 1. Next, what is that? This is core and this is support. Between these two. Between these two means that the set of all X such that whose membership values are equal to 0.5 is called bandwidth. Level set of a fuzzy set. So level set of a fuzzy set. Let A be a fuzzy set on X. The level set of capital A or an upper level subset or alpha set or alpha level set of capital A is given by, this is upper level set or upper level set, that's why it is said to be U of A. So A alpha equal to X belongs to X such that A of X greater than or equal to alpha. Alpha belongs to the closed interval 0, 1. For example, consider X equal to A, B, C, D, E. and let A be the fuzzy set as below. So we are given the membership values as like this. Okay. See, now I am taking alpha equal to 0.8 like this. 0.8 means that you have to consider those elements whose membership value is 0.8 and above. So B and D. Okay. Next, similarly, 1 to 10, I take it to be X, and I am considering a fuzzy set A. So elements of a fuzzy set A, capital A, I take it to be 1 to 6 only. So 7, 8, 9, 10, I am skipping means that automatically you have to understand that the membership values of that elements equal to 0. Okay. So 0.2, 0.5, 0.8, 1, 0.7, 0.3, like that I am given. Okay, A of 0.2. 0.2 means that for those elements whose value is greater than or equal to 0.2. So it has all those values. Similarly, 0.5 means that, so 2, 3, 1, what is that? 5 only exist. Okay. Similarly, 0.8, 1, 0.3, 0.7, also we can calculate. So these are level subsets. So for each and every level, above that, the elements whose membership value above this only collected for different values of alpha. So application. Application, while speaking about the applications, fuzzy set has so many applications. One of its application is washing machine. That is, washing machine, everybody handled the washing machine. Around the year 2000 to 2005, in that area, you have to see the washing machine means that it is a three-geared washing machine. There are three main functions: soaking, washing, drying. First, it will soak in that first gear. After that, next washing starts. That is the second gear. After that, drying. That is the third one. See, in the soaking, at the finishing stage, if there be any power cut, means that after power comes, it will start it from once again. Similarly, for the washing as well as the drying too. Okay, but at present washing machines having fuzzy controllers. In that washing machine label itself, you have to see means that they will indicate that having fuzzy controllers like that. Fuzzy controller means that if the process is ongoing, if there be any interruption, power supply, power cut, then after power comes, it starts from the original position where it stops. Okay, how? Using fuzzy controller, the initial stage, it has the value 0, okay, and in the final stage, it has a value 1, okay. In between, whenever it stops, the corresponding number has been recorded using sensors, okay. After the power comes, using the, once again, that reading the same number from that sensor, from that point only, it starts to work. The same process only DVD. In old DVD, if you see like this means that, whenever it stops means that automatically whenever the power comes, it resumes from the first one only. After that, later on, if you see the DVDs means that wherever it stops, it resumes from that place only. Some of the DVD displays that since the last memory like that, there is some number also. Okay, that having fuzzy controllers. That these are the things possible using fuzzy controllers only. Even though water purifier also, it works in like this. Each filter is nothing but a level set. 0, that is a salt water. 1 is nothing but the pure water. So by using each and every filter, suppose number of filters increases means that the softness of the water also be increased. So each level, that is one by one, the levels of that one is increased and given output as 1. Difference between probability and the fuzziness. You may have a question that fuzziness also deals between 0 and 1. And the probability also deals between 0 and 1. What is the main difference that? So many confusions, okay. So in almost all circumstances and all times, we find ourselves in a safe state of uncertainty. Uncertainty ranging from falling short of uncertainty to an almost complete lack of conviction or knowledge is attributed to many sources. So one source of uncertainty is randomness. There are two things here. One is randomness, another one is vagueness. Randomness is connected to probability theory and vagueness is connected to fuzzy set theory. Okay. So probability theory has long been used to measure and manage uncertainty problems that are due to randomness. Probability theory deals with a collection of well-defined events and predicts the chance of occurrence of each event. That's why it is said to be certain probability. Okay. Next one, vagueness. which results from imprecise information can also take us to a state of uncertainty. The theory of Fuzzy sets was introduced to measure and manage uncertainty problems that are due to vagueness. Fuzzy set theory deals with the collection of vague events and describes the degree of belongingness for each event. The theory of fuzzy sets was found to handle different types of uncertainty than the one modeled by probability theory, and it did not reject the fundamental tenets of probability. Tenets means that the laws and axioms of probability, it won't affect, it automatically follows in the fuzzy set theory. Fuzzy set theory results better than probability. Let us see example. Consider some number of bottles having milk. That is one example. Yeah, consider number of bottles having milk and some number of bottles having water. Also consider some number of bottles having mixture of water and milk. So if I say the probability of picking a bottle having milk is 0.7, it means that out of 100 bottles, you will have 30 bottles without milk at all. Is that right? Okay. On the other hand, if I say degree of truth of milk is given set of bottles is 0.7. It means that every bottle should contain milk, which is 70% of bottle volume. Okay. Summarizing the above example gives, if you pick a bottle with the probability 0.7 of having milk, there is a chance that you will end up with choosing a bottle which contains only water. Okay, it is a possibility because 30% possibility is there. On the other hand, if you pick a bottle with a membership value 0.7 of having milk, then there should be always a bottle having milk which is 70% of total volume. Sorry, each and every bottle should contain 70% of total volume of a milk, that it means. Fuzziness gives a grade or level of involvement, whereas probability gives a chance of involvement. For example, fuzziness of the water is poisoned is 0.6, means that the water is poisoned by containing 60% of poison. The probability of water is poisoned is 0.6, means there is a 60% chance of water being poisoned. So that is the difference. Probability uses for quantification how many occurrence and chance, all those things. And fuzziness uses for quantification how much. Okay, each and every work you can find out the fuzziness. Even though our FDV starts on 29th, now it is a 5th day. How much of the program has been completed? That is definitely a fuzziness only. Okay. And 1983, intuitionistic fuzzy set introduced by Atanasoff Ketty. Intuitionistic fuzzy sets are substantial extension of the ordinary fuzzy sets. They are objects having degrees of membership and non-membership such that their sum is exactly or less than 1. The most important property of intuitionistic fuzzy set is not shared by the fuzzy set. Is the model-like operators can be defined over intuitionistic fuzzy sets. These operators are not team fuzzy sets. The intuitionistic fuzzy sets have essentially higher describing probabilities than fuzzy sets. See, he is Atanasoff. In 1983, K.T. Atanasoff introduces the concept of intuitionistic fuzzy set. Intuitionistic fuzzy set is characterized by elements which have degrees of membership and non-membership. Mathematical definition: an intuitionistic fuzzy set A on a set capital X is defined as an object of the form A equal to set of all X, mu of X such that X belongs to X, where mu from capital X to close interval 0, 1 and nu capital X to close interval 0, 1 define the degree of membership and the degree of non-membership of the element X belongs to X respectively. And for every X belongs to X, the sum of membership value and non-membership value belongs to the closed interval 0, 1. See here, the membership mu of X denotes X satisfies the property A, and nu of X denotes X satisfies not the property of A. That is, property A means that, suppose if you take how is white means that, not property means that how is black, red, etc. Okay. Intuitionistic fuzzy set representation is useful when there are some uncertainties in assigning membership degrees. What is the meaning of this one? Suppose if there is a multiple choice question, four choices are there. By reading the question, if you are not able to locate the correct answer, you are having confusion, means that instead of finding the answer, you have to try to find out the wrong answer. Wrong answer, what I mean is, that is, you can use intrusive fuzzy set as a tool with the membership degree mu as the degree of correct answer. Next, and non-membership degree gamma as the degree of incorrect answer, wrong answer, and the hesitation degree, the degree associated with the questions failed to attempt. In this manner, we should first try to find out the wrong answers of this question. So if you eliminate that answers, then from among that remaining answer have some more appropriate membership than by including the wrong answer. In that case, we can use intrusistic fuzzy set. So this is a graphical representation of an intrusistic fuzzy set. Apart from membership value and non-membership value, another one function we can include, that is called a hesitation function. Hesitation function is nothing but 1 minus mu a of x minus nu a of x. Okay, so 1 minus membership value and another minus non-membership value. If hesitation of x equal to 0 means that there is no hesitation about x being an element of a or not. If hesitation of x equal to 1 means that there is a full hesitation as mu of x equal to 0. So this is a complete graphical representation of an intrusistic fuzzy set. I already told you that operators know. So these are the two operators. These operators are called necessity and the possibility operators. In these two cases only, what is it here? The hesitation function equal to 0. Hesitation function equal to 0 means that we don't have any hesitation that whether that element belongs to A or not. These are called moral operators of intrusistic fuzzy set. And application in that intrusistic fuzzy set you are considering means that while evaluating answers for the student's paper, say on 10 mark question you are correcting. Suppose you are giving 7 marks. 7 marks to that question means that then what automatically means that remaining that 30%. 7 marks you are giving means 70% you have to take. Remaining 30% you have to look up. There are two chances. Either he may not attempt. For all the things what he has attempted, you are writing 7 and 30% it is not enough. Okay. Next, or he is irrelevant to that one. That's the thing you have to look up. Okay. So, likewise for each question and each student, we are marking means that we can give coaching based on whether is they are irrelevant to that unit or irrelevant to the topic or they are not knowing, not aware of that. By understanding that, our coaching way different from different person to have effective result of that class. In 1994, bipolar fuzzy set has been introduced by W.R. Zhang. In 1994, Wenrang Zhang, Computer Science Department, Labor University, Baramount, USA, introduced the concept of bipolar valued fuzzy set or bipolar fuzzy set, and it is an extension of fuzzy set whose membership degree range is enlarged from the interval, that is 0, 1 to minus 1 to plus 1. For fuzzy set also, it ranges from 0, close interval 0, 1. And for intrusistic fuzzy set, there are two things, membership function and non-membership function, that also ranges 0, close interval 0, 1. But for bipolar fuzzy set, it is ranged from minus 1 to plus 1. So introduction of fuzzy set, I introduce fuzzy set in this manner, that is I am considering the concept young. Young I used to take the age group from 0 to 100 in this discussion. So I am considering the young as age of 25 to 35. So remaining thing, they are not young. Okay. So from that 0, I am giving the membership value. From the value 5, it slowly increases and reaches the value 1 at the age 20 and at the age 25 and it reaches up to that it is at the age 35. After that, it slowly decreases and reaches 0 at the age 55. Let us assume like this. So for 55 also, I am assigning the membership value as 0, and for 60 also 0, and for 65 also 0, like that, for 100 also 0. For the person who is of age 60 also having 0, and for the person who is having age 100 as membership as 0. By seeing this membership value 0, we are not able to find out the irrelevant to the given set, irrelevant to that age group N, like this according to this example. So to find out that irrelevant or contrary element only, bipolar sets has been used. See, mathematical definition, let X be a non-empty set. A bipolar set mu on X is an object having the form mu equal to X belongs to X comma mu plus of X and mu minus of X for all X belongs to X, where mu plus equal to set of all X from X from closed interval 0 comma 1 and mu minus equal to X from minus 1 comma 0 are mapping. The positive membership degree mu plus denotes the satisfaction degree of an element X to the property corresponding to mu. The negative membership degree mu minus denotes the satisfaction degree of an element X to some implicit counter property of A. This mu minus is denoted as a implicit counter property and mu plus is denoted as a counter property. The membership degree 0 means that elements are irrelevant to the corresponding property. The membership degree is on the interval, open interval 0, close interval 1 indicates that the elements somewhat satisfy the property. The membership degree on the interval closed 1, minus 1, open 0 indicates that the elements somewhat satisfy the implicit counter property. Mu plus denotes X satisfy the property of A. Mu minus denotes that X satisfies an implicit counter property of capital A. That is, property A, if you take curve is white means that implicit counter property of A, we have to take it to be curve is not white. Bipolar fuzzy set representation is useful when irrelevant elements and contrary elements are needed to be discriminated. See, this is a graphical representation. 55, at the age of 55, if it is equal to 0, after that we start from 0 to minus 1, we are giving the value. So from 0 to minus 1, I am giving the value as 100 means that for all those, the membership values are 0. Membership value means the counterpart is equal to 0. And the negative part means an implicit counterpart. Here you are ranging from 0 to minus 1. So if you take the age 70 means that the corresponding membership value is 0 and the corresponding non-membership value is that. If you take the value 100 means that membership value is 0 and the corresponding membership non-membership value is minus 1 like this. So from this, which one is closer to the property young, which one is so far away from the property young, that we can determine. We can easily determine the irrelevant elements. Application of bipolar fuzzy set. If you are having tablet, means that there are two things happening. One is effect and another one is side effect. Side effect is nothing but negative of the effect. So this negative of the effect can be denoted via bipolar fuzzy sets only. Previously we have defined two things. What is that? Fuzzy set and irreducible fuzzy set. These models are not available at that. So that only we have to go for bipolar fuzzy sets. In 2011, multi-fuzzy set, Sabu Sebastian introduced. So in 2011, Sabu Sebastian introduced the concept of multi-fuzzy set. Multi-fuzzy set is an extension of fuzzy set with a multi-phenomena. Its application play a vital role in science and engineering. The concept of fuzzy set is based on the single phenomena and it is not enough to find the accurate solution in many of the real life problems. The concept of multi-fuzzy set is an extension of fuzzy sets with a single phenomena into a fuzzy set with multi-phenomena, which suits to describe the real life problems in a better manner than fuzzy set. Mathematical definition, a multi-fuzzy set MFS capital A having dimension K in a non-empty set capital X is capital A equal to X mu 1 X mu 2 X etc. mu k of X, X belongs to capital X, where mu I from X to close interval 0 1 for all I belongs to 1. So here each one mu 1 mu 2 etc. mu k, everything is a memberships only. Okay, membership means that members of belongingness only it will denote. As well as multi-set of dimension 2 is not equal to intersystic fuzzy set, because intersystic fuzzy set also having two coordinates. One is membership and non-membership. But if some value belongs to close interval 0, 1. But here there is no restriction. Okay. Each one is belonging there. Each one can be equal to 1 also. So COVID-19, the present situation affects different people in different ways. Most affected people will develop mild to moderate illness and recover without hospitalization. Most common symptoms, fever, dry cough, tiredness. Less common symptoms, there are some list. And the serious common symptoms, there are some list. Okay. So, COVID-19 affected or not, it cannot be guessed by a single phenomenon from this we can follow. Okay. So for by taking a multi phenomenon, and we have to find out how much it has been affected, from that only it is possible to guess whether they affected by COVID-19 or not. According to that, either isolated from home and self-treatment or going to the hospital, according to the serious symptoms, we can guess. Similarly, I have one more application, a real application using multi-fuzzy set. As a class in charge, we are in the position to choose a leader of a class. If you choose a leader of a class based on the consideration of the multi-attributes of the students, instead of a single phenomenon based on marks or some other attributes, then it helps to handle the class in an effective manner. See, single phenomenon, what I mean is, suppose based on the mark, we can guess, or we can say, okay, you are the first mark of the class, we can be the leader of this class, or based on the boldness, okay, or based on the communication skill, we can fix any person, we can be the leader of the class. So instead of fixing that one, by considering the multi attributes of the students of the class, yeah, then the class leader can act in an effective manner to handle the class. For example, in a class, I am having 10 volunteer students to become a leader of the class A. Let us consider they are following multi attributes to select as a leader. First one, that is, I am considering these following attributes. What are the attributes? Leadership attributes or properties like that you can take. Okay, leadership quality, communication skills, obedience attitude, quick discussion, integrity, and computer knowledge. So based on each and every student's, let us grade their multi attributes using MFS, a multi fuzzy set, to the students as follows. So X1 is a student having like this 6 attributes. Similarly, X2, X4, up to X10. The above can be put into tabular form as follows. So B1, B2, etc. Mu6, and here X1, X2, etc. X10. So these are the values. Now, what is that? I am adding all those values and put it as a C as their total. If I put it as a total, means that there are 3 students having the same value. Okay. So X4, X6 and X10 are effective than others to handle the class as a leader. Okay. So among them, I wish to calculate only one person. Okay, let us see how. Let the value of Cj equal to summation of Vi, sum of all membership values of the attributes from I equal to 1 to 6, J equal to 1 to 10. Let us select a leader who have minimum value of C. Here, X4, X6 and X10 have the same value of C as 3.1. To find the best leader of the class capital A, let us allocate weights to the attributes in the following manner. See, now I am allocating the weights to the each attribute. Leadership quality and communication skill, obedience attitude, quick discussion, integrity, computer knowledge. Like that, I am fixing each and every attribute as a weight. Now, we calculate weighted choice value for each student as follows. See, weighted choice value means of first weight into the 0.7 plus second weight into the 0.4. Like this, we have to calculate and add and put it in the table, means that X10 only has a maximum value as 2.03. See, let the weighted choice value of the student be Cj, which is equal to weight into the membership value, whereas for all I equal to 1 to 6 and J equal to 1 to 10. The student X10 have the maximum value of C, is selected as a leader of the class and do his job in an effective manner. This is one real example by considering simple things only I am giving. So similarly, there are so many measures are there. Correlation measure, similarity measure, all those measures, if we have to consider, means that we can effectively find out solution to each and every of our real life problem. For example, you can convert the same problem into bridegroom and groom problem, as our need and want should be definitely not a single phenomenon, definitely a multi phenomenon. So you can put it in the table and you can select our best choice. Similarly, the same thing can be extended into a college hostel roommate selecting problems and so on like that. So this is a graphical representation of a multi-fuzzy set. Multi-fuzzy sets of dimension 6. See, for those 10 students, see X1, X2, etc. 10 students, for their six attributes, I am having a diagram of this man. By this, I conclude my presentation. Say, more fuzzy, if the person select to do their research in fuzzy means somebody do it in fuzzy, somebody do it in intrusionistic fuzzy, somebody do it in bipolar fuzzy, multi fuzzy, all those things only they are proceeding. Intrusionistic fuzzy, if they are doing means that they are thinking over that just by taking the concepts of fuzziness, and just if you have to add non-membership values or proof of that one in all those errors, then it is error. But there are something. What is that? Non-membership value means that we have to consider some applications related to this non-membership values, and then only we have to execute to the related concepts. Similarly, for bipolar fuzzy set, we have to take means that what is that? Bipolar fuzzy irrelevant concepts application we have to take, and we have to execute. And for multi-fuzzy means that instead of a single phenomena, we have to consider so many phenomena, and we have to consider various measures, and we have to use various measures and bring out the best results. Okay, these are some books for fuzzy to know about basic of fuzzy concepts, and these are my some of references. And let us have a discussion. And thank you to all for patiently listening.
Thank you, sir. I read some of the questions being posted in the chat box.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
What are the main advantages of intuitionistic fuzzy subsets?
Main advantages of intuitionistic fuzzy set, I already told you now, ma'am. Non-membership value. Non-membership value means that we are finding out some of the elements which is not a member. For a multiple choice question, I already told. If we have to find out the, which is not an answer to that question, can be easily eliminated. And for that membership, you can allocate the membership value for the remaining thing, and you can choose the appropriate.
Okay, there's another participant who has asked you to comment on marginal fuzzy set.
Marginal fuzzy set. Marginal fuzzy set, I don't have any idea. Fuzzy set.
Okay. One last question. Yes. As you said, complement of set is fuzzy set. According to the statement, intuitionistic fuzzy set is equal to a classical set. Or can you explain the difference between intuitionistic fuzzy set and classical set?
Intuitionistic, that is, in classical sets, all classical sets are fuzzy sets. That's all. Fuzzy sets, if you add non-membership quality to that one, then it is becomes intuitionistic fuzzy set. That's all.
Okay, sir. I think those are the questions which were asked. And as usual, they've asked you to share your PowerPoint, sir.
Definitely.
And a lot of compliments that your presentation has been with good clarity.
Thank you.
So now, thank you so much. I would like to propose the vote of thanks. Yesterday's lecture, Dr. Shivamani told us what is fuzziness, and fuzzy means things which are vague. So we kick-started the session with some of the fundamentals.
Yes.
And true that you took it as an extension, and your talk has been an eye-opener to all of us as to how we need to tackle such uncertainties through
yes.
further concepts of fuzzy logic.
Yes.
And thank you very much, sir, for giving us beautiful examples, saying that like you gave the example of a washing machine, mentioning
yes,
that there is no single standard for dirty laundry.
Yes,
I would
sir.
Put it that way. And I think that today's situation is fuzzy, and that's why we have included these topics. So fuzzy thinking, the fuzzy situation is all what is the present day scenario, and hope we all will use these concepts and try to build on this. So thank you very much. On behalf of Anand Institute of Higher Technology, I would like to thank all the participants who have been present here and showing your support. A big thanks to our technical team, Mr. Krishnan sir from EEE department, Professor VVR from EEE department, and Mr. Dinesh, who have been with us throughout the session. And a special thanks to our management once again. A humble request to the participants, I would like to inform, I don't know who is Ms.